Welcome to Minity Maths. In this video we will go through mean, median, mode and range questions that you may find on the GCSE exams. For a refresher on mean, median, mode and range, see our video linked above and in the description, below. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for weekly videos. Let's look at a typical GCSE style question. We are given the ages of a group of children and asked to find the mean, median, mode and range of these ages. For part 1, we need to find the mean. To do this, we add up all of the ages and divide by the number of children. We have 9 different ages here, so there are 9 children. If we divide 108 by 9, we get a mean age of 12. To work out the range, we need to find the difference between the highest age in the group, which is 15, and the lowest age, which is 10. To do this, we take 10 away from 15, and the answer is 5. To find the mode, we need to see which age occurs the most in the list. We can see that the ages 10 and 13 appear more than once. 10 occurs 3 times, while 13 only appears twice. Therefore, 10 is the mode. To find the median, we need to find the middle value in the list, once the list has been put in order. Here, the value of 12 is exactly halfway through the list. We can double-check this by counting the number of values on each side of the median. This next question requires us to find the missing number on the fourth card. We are given a clue that the mean of all 4 numbers is 10. Knowing this, we can form an equation. We will use the variable y to represent the missing value. Now let's rearrange the equation so we can solve it for y. Y equals 7, therefore the missing value is 7. You can check that this is correct by finding the mean of the 4 numbers, you should get an answer of 10. Here is a similar question to the last, except this time we are only given one of the numbers, but more clues. We need to find the missing 4 numbers. Firstly, we are told that the range is 6. We are already given the smallest number, as the cards are arranged in ascending order. So we can add the range of 6 to the smallest number, also 6. This means the largest number will be 12. This gives us a range of 6. Next, we are given the median number of 9. The median is the middle value, and as we have 5 cards, the middle value is the 3rd card. So we know this card is 9. We are now left with only 2 unknown values. Finally, we are told that the mean of the 5 cards is 9. Let's write this out using the formula for finding the mean. We can use the letters x and y to represent the 2 unknown values. Let's simplify and then rearrange this equation so we can work backwards to find the missing numbers. We can simplify this equation by adding up the numbers we already know, 6, 9 and 12. This gives us 27. Next, we can rearrange by multiplying both sides of the equation by 5, to get rid of the division. We now know that all 5 numbers must add up to 45. Let's get x and y on their own by taking away 27 from both sides of the equation. Now we know the 2 missing numbers must add up to 18. We can use trial and error to find 2 numbers between 6 and 12 which add up to 18. The first missing value, which we have named x, could either be 6, 7, 8 or 9. The second missing value, which we have named y, could either be 9, 10, 11, or 12. Have a look at these numbers and see if any of these add up to exactly 18. there are four pairs of these numbers which add up to 18. 6 plus 12. 7 plus 11. 8 plus 10. And 9 plus 9. Therefore, any of these pairs could be used in your answer. Thanks for watching, and good luck in your exams. Check out our channel for more GCSE revision videos.